proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
After Jesus had fed the 5,000 men, his disciples saw him walking on the sea. The next day, the crowd that remained across the sea saw that there had been only one boat there, and that Jesus had not gone along with his disciples in the boat, but only his disciples had left. Other boats came from Tiberias, near the place where they had eaten the bread, when the Lord gave thanks. When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. And when they found him across the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you get here?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you are looking for me, not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him the Father, God, has set his seal." So they said to him, "What can we do to accomplish the works of God?" Jesus answered and said to them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in the one he sent." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As an OFW, we migrate to another country to work for greener pasture, to work for financial stability. But somehow it's okay that we work for our family. But as Christian, Jesus also reminds us in today's gospel. Jesus said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you are looking for me, not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled." This is the continuation of the gospel with Jesus multiplying the bread to feed the 5,000 men, excluding women and children. So, as Christian, therefore, our goal is to work for spiritual, for eternal. People were looking because they ate the bread that Jesus multiplied, and so Jesus knew their minds, their motivation, why they follow him. They want only the bread. They want only material things. That's why Jesus said, "Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you." So, our duty as Christian, not only material, not only to pray, Lord, give me this one word. What if the Lord will not grant our prayers? Will we continue to follow the Lord? Lord, I ask the Lord. I ask for the house, Lord. I'm not going to have the Lord. Goodbye, Lord. Come on. Okay? But sometimes, if the Lord doesn't grant our prayers, nagtatampo tayo. Yeah, but the Lord reminds us. We work for, look for the food that do not perish, meaning that is spiritual, eternal. And that is what St. Stephen in today's first reading. He asked for, you know, wisdom. Stephen asked not just material, no? But he asked for faith, for that wisdom. And because of that, nobody can take that wisdom. That's why the Sanhedrin, those in authority, wanted to destroy Stephen and make false accusation of Stephen, because they cannot refute, they cannot overcome the wisdom of Stephen. That meaning, when we pray something that is eternal, spiritual. Like Solomon, remember Solomon? When Yahweh told Solomon, "Ask anything that you want, and I will grant you." Maybe Solomon can ask for more military money, but you know what Solomon asked the Lord? Do you remember the meaning of Solomon? Wisdom. And because that is eternal, that also Solomon was blessed. So if we ask something that is eternal, that is our way to prosperity. That is our way to financial stability. Not only just Lord, and the Lord can have word. Lord, give me this of this word. But Lord, grant me the wisdom. Lord, help me to persevere, strengthen my faith, Lord, that even in the midst of poverty, in the times of trials, I will not give up to you, Lord. Even that sometimes, Lord, that you will not answer my prayer, my request, help me, Lord, to persevere. So we ask something that is spiritual to sustain us. Not only just temporal. But temporal, temporal is just temporal. When we pray for material, it is temporal. Ask something that is spiritual. Because spiritual, that is eternal. When we have something that is spiritual, it will affect also our spirit, our financial life, our physical. But if you have something material, does not affect our spiritual. But if us speak spiritual, it will affect our physical material. That's why Jesus said, remember that before? Seek ye first the kingdom of God, and everything will be given to you. Pag-unahin mo si Lord, hindi ka mag-unan. Pero pag-unahin mo yung sarili, kulang-kulang ka. Kailangan kulang. Pag-unahin mo si Lord, hindi ka mag-unan. That's why if we make God to be first, then everything will be provided for the Lord. That's why Jesus said, do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures to eternity. Meaning, we have to pray, we have to follow the way of God, we have to read the word of God. So it's the challenge for us. That's why the question of, are we working for our spiritual improvement? Okay. Are we working to improve our relationship with the Lord? Or baka natatrabaho lang tayo for ourselves? Diba, sometimes, nagpo-kuskos na tayo para tayo. Nagpo-kuskos na tayo para sa sarili, para may pera. But do we spend extra time for the Lord? Sometimes it's a challenge for us. And maybe after Mass, we can spend time for the Lord. Thank the Lord personally. After the Mass, we have kagawain that we can stay to listen to the Word of God. If kung nagkuskus tayo para maka-extra word, why not also kuskus para kay Lord give extra time in the Lord? Amen? That's why to believe the plan of God, the work of God, that is our salvation. The Gospels and the people said, what can we do to accomplish the works of God? What can we do? And Jesus told them, this is the work of God, that you believe in the one He sent. That is the plan of God, that is in Jesus Christ, and we believe the ways of Jesus. Because Jesus said, I am the bread of life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. That in salvation, therefore, is to follow the ways of Jesus. And that is salvation, the work of God, that you believe in the one who sent you. We believe Jesus is the way to eternity. There is no other way to eternity. And so the readings today reminds us that Jesus is reminding us that we ask not just temporal, ask something eternal. Because when you ask that is eternal, nobody can will take you. Just like nobody can take that gift from you. Just like Stephen, so much wisdom and the Sanhedrin people in authority was overcome by the wisdom of Stephen. And so they were envy, they want to destroy Stephen. Okay. So ask the Lord something that is spiritual, something that is eternal. Ask the gift, a gift for wisdom, a gift for more patience, a gift to be more, you know, loving others, forgiving others. Ask something that, Lord, give me the gift, Lord, the humility to forgive. Did you pray? Did you ask the Lord? Help me, Lord, to forgive this person. But sometimes we do not pray. We want to retaliate, revenge. But pray. Ask something. That's why we are always hankering for revenge. Because we do not pray for the gift to forgive, to reconcile. And so, in this Mass, we ask the grace of God that we may persevere in our discipleship, in following Him. And Jesus is reminding us today, in the Gospel today, as Jesus said, do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures to eternal life. Amen.